used to love it, but Mummy would never let me have it. She thought it was common. Now, Blackpool, what can you tell us?
In 1884, the first electric tramway in Great Britain was inaugurated here.
And there are plenty more facts to come. We'll be celebrating the Great Northern Woman, the weather, the thrills, and the piers, and so much more. All right, let's go. Where to first? Of course, it's time to check in.
Dinner at 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
Breakfast at 9 o'clock. Hope you enjoy yourself.
Blackpool has 3,500 hotels, guest houses and holiday flats. They claim that's more than all the Greek islands put together, and more beds than the whole of Portugal. And those dragons of the B&B, who terrorise generations of holidaymakers, are now a thing of the past, and visitors want a homely touch.
You really do get to know people very well. You know just what they want, you know just what they want, what sort of bedding they want on. Some won't even have duvets, they still like the blankets. One will have marmalade and one would like jam to follow the breakfast. And if they come as a customer, they go away as a friend.
No wonder they're packing them in.
We used to get parties and then it didn't matter if you'd only bet for 30 and 45k. Three in a bed, there was no objection to it. They liked to do it, but not today.
Three in a bed? But then, Blackpool hoteliers have always had a reputation as the most shrewd of businesswomen.
It's 20 years ago now since I purchased the President Hotel, and of course you're always looking for improvement.
Mrs. Walsh is coming in to have a meeting with us. I haven't got a clue what it's about.
And what's Mrs. Walsh like?
Tough.
Yes, whatever it is you call entertainment, Blackpool will have it.
My dear wife, after years of bliss, you ran away last week with a fella next door, and I do miss him. Now, this is what makes it so nostalgic to come to Blackpool. I met the wife in Blackpool on the Pleasure Beach, in the Tunnel of Love. She was digging it.
Being top of the bill in Blackpool for the summer season used to be a sign that you were the nation's favourite act.
This is a commemorative roll of honour for people who performed at the Blackpool Opera House. Bang! Chaplin performed here. This is music hall and vaudeville. It's the birth of show business in this country. Vera Lynn. Terry Thomas. Hello. I say, you're rather lovely, aren't you? And then the last 3 years, Joe Longford, David Essex and Bradley Walsh. It's phenomenal. I mean, it's an amazing thing to go from Wilson Barrett and Charlie Chaplin to Bradley Walsh.
Whether you're a fan of Bradley Walsh or Charlie Chaplin, it's clear that Blackpool has played host to the very best in British entertainment. But you don't have to go to the theatre to have fun.
Hurry, hurry, hurry! I chose that Blackpool wait the eyes of the curious. Fattest and thinnest, tallest and shortest. Blackpool has them all. The best and biggest freak show on earth. Crowds roll up. Stop and stare, feel a little pity perhaps, and move off to where there's more fun to say.
All the theatrical razzmatazz of bingo is larger and livelier and twice as much fun in Blackpool.
The challenge for us is, how do we transport today's sophisticated city dweller with a bottle of Evian in one hand and a baguette in the other? What do we deliver here that is a wow factor for them?
Now this is a true visionary. No simulated trees for this man. He has a more culinary approach.
This is the new seawalls going in. This is the cake we're making. When that's complete, then we layer a very thick layer of marzipan and icing on top.
And as far as cake decorations go, you won't get more impressive than this. It's Britain's largest disco ball.
The high wind gave Mr. Chamberlain the top crossing to France right to Blackpool. But Blackpool can take it.
Thank you.
find a place where people really do come to let their hair down. They've let their hair down even before they've got off their coaches.